وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تتقون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way He deserves to be praised. And we ask Allah to exalt the mention, grant peace, and send His blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters in faith, Alan wa Salan bikum. Here we are on embarking on a new chapter in our journey to the understanding of the names and attributes of Allah as per the way of the righteous predecessors, the saved and aided sect, the people that have been promised salvation, the people that will not enter the fire, the people that will reside in paradise and Firdaus, and those who will be close to the prophets and the messengers. We beg Allah Azza wa Jal to make us among them. In spite of our shortcomings, in spite of our lousy efforts, in spite of our limitation in doing good deeds, but our love for them, we hope and pray we will have the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, who said, "Al-mar'u ma' man ahab," the man will be with the one whom he loves. And we make Allah bear witness that we love them. We love the Sahaba from the bottom of our hearts. We love the righteous predecessors. We love the generations that followed them. And of course, we love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hoping that that love will be of benefit for us on the last day. So let us discuss ithbatul ism lillah, the affirmation of the name for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the sharh, the Shaykh says, ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله آية في إثبات الاسم لله تعالى وآيات أخرى كثيرة في تنزيه الله تعالى ونفي المثيل عنه. So the author, may Allah have mercy on him, mentioned a single ayah in affirming the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, and he mentioned many other ayat in terms of exalting Allah Azza wa Jal above any imperfection, and also negating the likeness to Him, that there could be anything like Allah Azza wa Jal. As for the ithbat, ayatu ithbat al-ism, in Surah Al-Rahman, ayah number 78, تبارك اسم ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام. Blessed be the name of your Lord, the owner of majesty and honor. تبارك قال العلماء معناها تعالى وتعاظم إن وصف بها الله. So if Allah is described with this particular term, تبارك or blessed, it means exalted and proud. How exalted and proud is Allah Azza wa Jal when He's described with it. فَكَقَوْلِهِ فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Such as the statement of Allah, so blessed be Allah, the best of creators. وَإِنْ وُصِفَ بِهَا إِسْمُ اللَّهِ. This is if Allah Himself is described with Tabarak. Okay? However, if the name of Allah is described with being blessed, كَانَ مَعْنَاهَا أَنَّ الْبَرَكَةَ تَكُونُ بِإِسْمِ اللَّهِ. The meaning will become that blessing is associated and accompanies the name of Allah. أي أن اسم الله إذا صاحب شيئا صارت فيه البركة. Meaning the name of Allah, if it ever accompanies anything, that thing will have an abundance of blessings. ولهذا جاء في الحديث. That's why it comes in a particular hadith. And this hadith, يعني the علماء have differed on its authenticity, but Ahmad Shakir and Shu'aib al-Arnaut have authenticated this particular hadith from the Musnad of Imam Ahmad. Bismillah. I'm sorry, those are the ones who said that there's a'allahu akharun, there's an error in it, as it says in the footnote. I'm actually reading the footnote. على كل حال كل أمر ذي بال لا يبدأ فيه بسم الله فهو أبتر. Every matter of importance that is not started, that it does not begin with Bismillah, is severed, meaning it will lack prosperity. أي ناقص البركة, meaning it will not have any barakah. So this hadith has been narrated by many different narrators and different chains, and all of them strengthen each other, rendering the hadith to be hasan or sahih, meaning good or a sound chain of narrations. And others have said otherwise, but that's besides the point right now. And so once we have some opinion that says authentic, we can use it in this regard. بل إن تسمية تفيد حل الشيء الذي حل الشيء أو حل الشيء الذي يحرم بدونها ها بدونها. Very important. Actually, تسمية will render something permissible that is prohibited otherwise. Meaning something can be prohibited otherwise, and basmala is that thing, the tasmiya that mention the name of Allah will render that thing halal before that it wasn't. فإنه إذا سمى الله على الذبيحة صارت حلالا. If you mention the name of Allah upon slaughtering the animal, it becomes permissible and lawful. وإذا لم يسمي صارت حراما وميتا. And if you don't mention the name of Allah, it becomes prohibited and a form of dead flesh. وهناك فرق بين الحلال الطيب الطاهر والميت النجس الخبيث. And there's a tremendous difference between the pure and lawful good, that which is halal, as in the animal, and then a dead flesh that is filthy and impure. وإذا سمى الإنسان على طهارة الحدث صحت وإذا لم يسمي لم تصح على أحد القول على أحد القولين. And if a person was to say and mention the name of Allah upon purification from for wudu from the minor impurity, if you were to mention the name of Allah, then your wudu is sound. And if you were not to mention, then wudu is not sound according to one of the two opinions. Because some scholars say that it's obligatory to say the name of Allah, and some say that it's not, and that your wudu is still valid even if you don't mention, even if you don't say Bismillah. وإذا سمى الإنسان على طعامه لم يأكل معه الشيطان وإن لم يسمي أكل معه. And if a person were to mention name of Allah upon eating, the shaitan does not eat with him. And if he were to not mention name of Allah, the shaitan will eat with him. وإذا سمى الإنسان على جماعه وقال اللهم جنبنا الشيطان وجنب الشيطان ما رزقتنا. And if a person were to mention name of Allah upon engaging in intercourse, sexual intercourse, and he were to say, oh Allah, keep the shaitan away from us, and keep us away from the shaitan, and keep the shaitan away from what you will provide for us. ثم قدر بينهما ولد. Then Allah decreed that they will have a child. لم يضره الشيطان أبدا. The shaitan will never harm him. وإن لم يفعل. And if he were not to make the name, mention name of Allah, فالولد عرضة لضرر الشيطان. So that person or that child will be vulnerable to the harm of the shaitan. وعليه فنقول. Therefore we say, إن فتبارك هنا ليست بمعنى تعالى وتعاظم بل يتعين أن يكون معناها حلت البركة باسم الله. So in this context, the Sheikh said, it becomes obligatory to understand that, not obligatory, he said, yeah, يتعين, yes, it's compulsory to understand that تبارك here does not mean proud and honorable, that Allah Azza wa Jal is exalted and proud. Rather, the meaning is the barakah, the blessing of Allah is established via the mention of His name. أي أن اسمه سبب للبركة إذا صحب شيئا. Meaning that His name is a source of blessing when it accompanies something. وقوله ذي الجلال والإكرام. ذي بمعنى صاحب. ذي, the owner of majesty and honor. The meaning the owner of. وهي صفة لرب. And it is a description for the term Lord. لا لإسم. Not a description for the word name. Huh? It is a description for رب. تبارك اسم ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام. So the is describing تبارك اسم رب. تبارك اسم ربك. ربك. It is a description for the term رب. Not تبارك اسم for اسم. لو كانت صفة الاسم لكانت ذو. Had it been a description for the اسم, it would have been ذو and not ذي. And as you know, that depends on the position of the sentence, of the word in the sentence. Meaning, it would have been مرفوع. It would not have been منصوب or مجرور in this sense. تمام. والجلال بمعنى العظمة. جلال meaning magnificence and majesty. والإكرام بمعنى التكريم. And إكرام meaning to honor. وهو صالح لأن يكون الإكرام من الله لمن أطاعه وممن أطاعه له. And this is valid. This is valid that Allah Azza wa Jal is, it's applicable. That this is an honor from Allah to the one who obeys Him and also to Allah Azza wa Jal. فالجلال عظمته في نفسه. So جلال is the magnificence in and within himself. والإكرام عظمته في قلوب المؤمنين فيكرمونه ويكرمهم. And إكرام, the honor, is his majesty and exaltation in the hearts of the believers. Therefore, they honor him and Allah Azza wa Jal honors them. تمام؟ So, now, this was the ayah to establish the name of Allah. The name for Allah. Now, آيات الصفات المنفية في تنزيه الله ونفي المثل عنه. Now we will discuss with the ayat, with the attributes of negation, in that basically exalt Allah Azza wa Jal above any imperfection, and also the negation of having an equal to Him. The negation of having an equal to Him. الآية الأولى قوله فاعبده واصطبر لعبادته هل تعلم له سميا. So worship him and be constant in patience in his worship. Do you know of any who is similar to him? شرح المؤلف رحمه الله بالصفات السلبية أي صفات النفي. شرع المؤلف رحمه الله بالصفات السلبية أي صفات النفي. So now the author, may Allah mercy on him, had began the discussion with the attributes of negation, which are known the attributes of negation. وقد مر علينا فيما سبق أن صفات الله عز وجل ثبوتية وسلبية. We've already established in the book that the attributes of Allah are of two types, either affirmative or negative. Either affirmative or negative. أي منفية لأن الكمال لا يتحقق إلا بالإثبات والنفي. Because perfection cannot be established until you affirm certain things and you negate others. إثبات الكمالات, the affirmation of the perfection. ونفي النقائص and the negation of the imperfections. قوله فاعبده واصطبر لعبادته. Type. So worship him and be constant and patient in his worship. الفاء مفرعة على ما سبق. So now we're going to go linguistically a little bit. So the فاء is basically a branching off from what has preceded. وهي قوله رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما, the Lord of the heavens and the earth and what is between them. فذكر سبحانه وتعالى ربوبية. So Allah عز وجل mention his lordship, رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما. وفرع على ذلك وجوب عبادته. And a byproduct and a consequence and a branching of his ربوبية is the obligation of worshiping him alone. لأن كل من أقر بالربوبية لزمه الإقرار بالعبودية والألوهية. Whosoever affirms lordship to Allah is obliged to also affirm servitude and divinity. Whosoever affirms the rububiyyah of Allah is obliged to affirm servitude and divinity to Allah alone. وَإِلَّا صَارَ مُتَنَاقِدًا. Otherwise he will be contradicting himself. The whole subject matter will become contradictory. فَقَوْلُهُ فَاعْبُدْهُ. So the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, فَاعْبُدْهُ, meaning so worship him. أي تذلل له محبة وتعظيما, meaning subjugate yourself in humiliation and reverence. Subjugate yourself in love and reverence. والعبادة يراد بها المتعبد به. And what is intended with عبادة is that which is used as means of worship. ويراد بها التعبد الذي هو فعل العبد. And what could also be intended is the act of worship itself, that the action, meaning either the act of worship or the person doing the act of worship, the action of the person regarding that act of worship. كما سبق في المقدمة, as we have said in the introduction. وقوله واصطبر, اصطبر أصلها في اللغة اصطبر with a تاء. فأبدلت التاء طاء لعلة تصريفية. Anyways, a linguistic breakdown of why the تاء was replaced with طاء for something that has to do with grammar and conjugation. والصبر حبس النفس. So صبر is being able to hold yourself back. وكلمة اصطبر أبلغ من اصبر. And the term اصطبر is more emphatic than اصبر. Meaning be patient, be very patient, we would say, be constant, is stronger than merely saying, be constant in patience is stronger than saying merely be patient. لأنها تدل على معاناة, because it signifies a struggle. فالمعنى اصبر وان شق عليك ذلك. So the meaning is be patient even if you face difficulty in doing so. واثبت ثبات القرين لقرينه في القتال. And have the patience of the person who is patient in the battlefield with his friend against his opponent. The one who will persevere with the person against his opponent. وقوله لعبادته قيل إن اللام بمعنى على أي اصطبر عليها كما قال تعالى وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها. It is said that اللام means على meaning upon just such as the other ayah and command your family and your family to pray and be patient upon doing so. وقيل بل اللام على أصلها and it was said that the lamb is in its original state أي اصطبر لها meaning be patient for it أي كن مقابلا لها بالصبر meaning meet that difficulty with patience. كما يقابل القرين قرينه في ميدان القتال. Such just like a person will fight his opponent in the battlefield. أي نعم. واثبت ثبات القرين قرينه في القتال. Yeah, meaning that your opponent, not your friend against your opponent. I'm sorry. وقوله هل تعلم له سمية. Now comes the point of discussion. Do you know of any who is similar to him? الاستفهام للنفي. This kind of interrogative sentence is actually intending, the intention behind it is negation. And we've learned this before. وإذا كان الاستفهام بمعنى النفي, and if as an interrogative sentence comes in the context of negation, كان مشربا معنى التحدي. It is engulfed and it has fully absorbed the meaning of challenge. So it is a challenge. Whenever Allah Azza wa Jal uses in the Quran a question, whenever there's a question, but that question is in the context of negation, meaning Allah is challenging the people for the opposite. يعني إن كنت صادقا, meaning if you are truthful, فأخبرنا, then tell us, هل تعلم له سمية? Do you know any who is similar to him? والسمي الشبيه والنظير. سمي, meaning that which is equal or that which is similar. يعني هل تعلم له مساميا أو نظيرا يستحق مثل اسمه. Do you know anyone that is similar to him therefore deserving a name like his? والجواب لا. The answer is no. Excuse me. فإذا كان كذلك, if it is such, فالواجب أن تعبده وحده, then what's obligatory upon you is to worship him alone. وفيها من الصفات قوله هل تعلم له سمية وهي من الصفات السلبية. So among the attributes of Allah that we learn from this is, do you know any similar to him and anything that is similar to him or anyone who's similar to him, and that is from the attributes of negation. فما الذي تتضمنه من صفات الكمال. Okay, if this is an attribute of negation, then what does it contain of the attributes of perfection? لأننا ذكرنا فيما سبق أن الصفات السلبية لا بد أن تتضمن ثبوتا. We've previously mentioned that any attribute of negation must include an affirmation in the opposite. فما هو الثبوت الذي تضمنه النفي هنا. What is that which is being affirmed that is understood from the negation here? الجواب الكمال المطلق. The answer is absolute perfection. فيكون المعنى. So the meaning really becomes, هل تعلم له سميا لثبوت كماله المطلق الذي لا يسمي في أحد فيه. Do you know anyone who is equal to him in his absolute perfection that no one can even be similar to him, so that nobody is similar to him? Do you understand? Good. الآية الثانية, the second ayah, قوله ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. This one all of you know, alhamdulillah, and there is none co-equal to him. تقدم الكلام فيها. We've previously spoken about this. أي ليس يكافئه أحد, meaning no one can be equal to him. وهي نكرة في سياق النفي فتعم, and it is once again an indefinite pronoun in the context of negation, so it becomes general. It is encompassing in the meaning that it delivers. وكفواً, the term كفواً فيها ثلاث قراءات. It has three different recitations. Pay attention now. Pay attention now. The term كفواً has three different قراءات, meaning it is read in three different ways. Sorry, I just have something that is blocking my view, and I'm so particular and finicky about my glasses being 100% clear. silly human being. Kufuan wa kuf'an wa kuf'u wa kufu'an. So there are three different recitations. Kufuan wa kuf'an wa kufu'an. أو وكفو كفو أي نعم فهي بالهمزة الساكنة ساكنة الفاء ومضمومتها. So there's one version where the همزة is sound is neutral, the فاء is neutral and has a ضمة وبالواو مضمومة الفاء. Anyways we're not gonna delve into that. It's just different ways of قراءات, and this is from the these are from the things that have been conveyed to us from the Sahaba all the way up until now. And this is from the majesty and the greatness of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, that there are different qira'at, all of which have been preserved. And we have been told about it. So no one can play silly games in this regard. هذه الآية أيضا فيها نفي الكفء لله عز وجل. This ayah also has a negation of Allah having co-equals. وَذَلِكَ لِكَمَالِ صِفَاتِهِ. That's because of the perfection of his attributes. فَلَا أَحَدْ يُكَفِئُهُ. No one can be equal to him. لَا فِي عِلْمِهِ, not in his knowledge. وَلَا سَمْعِهِ, not in his hearing. وَلَا بَصَرِهِ, not in his vision. وَلَا قُدْرَتِهِ, not in his power. وَلَا عِزَّتِهِ, not in his might. وَلَا حِكْمَتِهِ, not in his wisdom. وَلَا غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ صِفَاتِهِ, nor any of his other attributes. No one can be equal to Allah عز وجل. الآية الثالثة قوله فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون. The third ayah is then do not set up rivals unto Allah while you know. هذا مفرع على قوله. This is a branching off from the statement of Allah عز وجل. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Oh, you have believed, or oh, mankind, I'm sorry, worship your Lord who created you and those who were before you so that you may have taqwa. Who has made the earth a resting place for you and the sky a canopy and sent down water from the sky and brought forth therewith fruits as a provision for you. الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم وكل هذا من توحيد الربوبية. All this is establishing the توحيد of ربوبية, and then Allah says ثم قال, then Allah says فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا. Then do not set up rivals unto Allah. يعني في الألوهية, meaning in His divinity. لأن أولئك القوم المخاطبين, because those people that are being spoken to, لم يجعلوا لله أندادا في الربوبية. They did not make rivals to Allah in ربوبية. رحم الله الشيخ بن عثيمين. رحم الله الشيخ بن عثيمين وشتان ما بين بن عثيمين وواي كي واي كي واي وي 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 بي 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 شتان ما بين الاثنين. والله the difference between the heavens and the earth, between العالم الرباني الشيخ بن عثيمين رحم الله and those individuals that speak on behalf of Muslims today, those ruwaybida, the people that are being addressed in this ayah, they did not make equals to Allah in rububiyyah. إذن فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا في الألوهية. Therefore do not make rivals unto Allah in divinity. كما أنكم تقرون أن ليس له أندادا في ربوبية. Just like you admit that Allah does not have any rivals in ربوبية. Everybody knows Allah is the Lord and the creator of the heavens and the earth. Everybody knows that that idol or statue didn't create Jack. They all know that. But they thought they had a special connection with Allah. They will intercede for you with Allah. They have a special status with Allah. So we use them as an intermediary to get to Allah. That's what's up. But today we want to play with the basics. وَقَوْلُهُ أَنْدَادًا. The statement is أَنْدَادًا, meaning rivals. جَمْعُ نِد is the plural of نِد. وَنِدُّ الشَّيْءِ ما كان منادا, meaning and the opposite of something or the rival of something is that which is which has a rival. أي مكافئا له مشابه, meaning that which is equal and similar to it. وما زال الناس يقولون هذا ند لهذا, and people until now they say this thing, this person is a rival to that one. أي مقابل له ومكافئ له, meaning similar to him and close to him, and in that sense. وقوله وأنتم تعلمون, while you know. الجملة هنا حالية وصاحب الحال هي الواو في قوله لا تجعل والمفعول محذوف. A lot of grammar. A lot of grammar. Let me go to the thing. أي نعم. So the bottom line is كأنه قال, as if Allah is saying, do not set up rivals with Allah, because you know that He has no rivals. So if you know that, how is it that you're going against your very knowledge? How is it that you're setting up rivals to Allah, going against what you already know, that He doesn't have any? وَهَذِهِ أَيْضًا سَلْبِيَّةً. This is also a negative attribute here. وَذَلِكَ مِنْ قَوْلِهِ. And that is derived from the statement, فَلَا تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا, أي لِأَنَّهُ لَا نِدَّ لَهُ لِكَمَالِ صِفَاتِ. Meaning, do not set up rivals unto Allah, because He has no rivals because of the perfection of His attributes. الآية الرابعة, the fourth ayah, قوله ومن الناس من يتخذ من دون الله أندادا يحبونهم كحب الله. And among and of mankind are some who take others besides Allah as rivals. They love them as they love Allah. ومن طبعيدية والميزان لمن الطبعيدية أن يحل محلها بعض, يعني بعض الناس, meaning some people. Here it is that it means some of them. ما يتخذ من دون الله أندادا يتخذهم أندادا يعني في المحبة, meaning they set up these rivals to Allah, they make these rivals in their love. كما فسره بقوله, as Allah explained it on his own in the ayah, يحبونهم كحب الله, they love them like they love Allah. ويجوز أن نقول, and it is permissible for us to say إن المراد بالأنداد ما هو أعم من المحبة. We could actually say what is intended by rivals is what is even vaster than merely love. يعني أندادا يعبدونهم كما يعبدون الله, meaning they have rivals that they worship them as they worship Allah. وينذرون لهم كما ينذرون لله, and the نذر is not an oath, subhanAllah, what is the word? Vow. And they make vows for them like they ought to make vows for Allah. لأنهم يحبونهم كحب الله, because they love them as they're supposed to love Allah. يحبون هذه الأنداد كحب الله عز وجل, they love those rivals as the way they should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهذا إشراك في المحبة, and this is a form of associating partners with Allah in love. بحيث تجعل غير الله مثل الله في محبته, wherein you make other than Allah equal to Allah in your love. وينطبق ذلك, pay attention now, and that is this kind of shirk in love, this kind of shirk in love, listen to this now. وينطبق ذلك على من أحب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كحب الله. This also applies to the one who loves the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم as he loves Allah. لأنه يجب أن تحب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم محبة ليست كمحبة الله, because you ought to love the messenger of Allah عليه وسلم, a type of love that is unlike the love of Allah. لأنك إنما تحب الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم تبعا لمحبة الله عز وجل, because you only love the messenger as a byproduct of loving Allah, as means of following what your love for Allah. لا على أنه مناد لله, not that he is a rival to Allah. فكيف بمن يحبون الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر مما يحبون الله. How about then those who love the messenger of Allah more than they love Allah? And of course you see those people all over the place among the ummah, all these those who are falling into shirk among the ummah and calling on the Prophet ﷺ, the level of obsession and fascination that they have with the Messenger of Allah exceeds the love of Allah, to the point that they're willing to commit shirk. They're willing to commit shirk and violate tawheed in order to display their love for the Messenger of Allah. Do you understand how those people, especially in the Mawlid and those events where they go to extreme and they, you know, jump around and they claim the Prophet ﷺ visited them and all that nonsense that these people do? You see how serious the subject matter is? Their love for the Messenger of Allah exceeds their love for Allah, because they're willing to compromise tawheed and obedience to Allah to make out of a fake expression of their love to the Messenger of Allah عليه السلام. وهنا يجب أن نعرف الفرق بين المحبة مع الله والمحبة لله. Here we should know the difference that between, recognize the difference, the distinction between the love along with Allah and loving Allah. المحبة مع الله, loving along with Allah, أن تجعل غير الله مثله في محبته أو أكثر, وهذا الشرك, is that you make other than Allah equal to him or even more in your love for them, and that is shirk. والمحبة في الله أو لله, or loving for Allah, loving يعني for the sake of Allah or for Allah, هي أن تحب الشيء تبعا لمحبة الله عز وجل, is that you love something out of love for Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the sublime. والذي نستفيده من الناحية المسلكية في هذه الآيات, what do we benefit in terms of behavior, from a behavioral perspective. أولا في قوله تبارك اسم ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام, blessed be the name of your Lord, the owner of majesty and honor. إذا علمنا أن الله تعالى موصوف بالجلال, if we know Allah عز وجل is described with honor, with majesty, فإن ذلك يستوجب أن نعظمه وأن نجله. This necessitates that we should magnify him and we should exalt him. وإذا علمنا أنه موصوف بالإكرام, and if we know that Allah عز وجل is described with honor, فإن ذلك يستوجب أن نرجو كرمه وفضله. That necessitates that we should beg and hope for Allah's honor and generosity. وبذلك نعظمه بما يستحقه من التعظيم والتكريم. Therefore, we are able to, to exalt Allah in a manner that befits him in terms of his majesty and honor. ثانيا, secondly, قوله فاعبده واصطبر لعبادته. So worship him and be consistent and patient in his worship. فالفوائد المسلكية في ذلك هو أن يعبد العبد ربه. So the behavioral benefit is that the slave should worship his Lord, ويصطبر للعبادة, and should be patient in doing so. لا يمل, you don't become bored. ولا يتعب, you don't become tired. ولا يضجر, you don't become impatient. You don't become impatient. بل يصبر عليها صبر القرين قرينه في المبارزة في الجهاد. Rather, he remains patient, just like an opponent in the struggle in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثالثا, قوله هل تعلم له سمية. Do you know a co-equal to him? Do you know anything that is similar to him? ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Do you know anything that is co-equal to him? فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا. So do not set up rivals onto Allah. ففيها تنزيه لله عز وجل. This has the glorification of, and basically exalting Allah above any imperfection. وأن الإنسان يشعر في قلبه بأن الله تعالى منزع عن كل نقص, and that you feel in your heart, you as a human feel in your heart that Allah عز وجل is exalted above any deficiency. وأنه لا مثيل له, that Allah has no similar, no one that is similar, ولا ند له, and no rival unto him. وبهذا يعظمه حق تعظيمه بقدر استطاعته, and therefore you're able to exalt him to the best of your ability. رابعا, fourthly, قوله ومن الناس من يتخذ من دون الله أندادا, and among the people are those who take on rivals with Allah. فمن فوائدها من الناحية المسلكية, one of the benefits from the behavioral aspects, أنه لا يجوز للإنسان أن يتخذ أحدا من الناس محبوبا كمحبة الله. وهذه تسمى المحبة مع الله, that you, it is not permissible for you to take anyone among the people to be beloved to you the same way you love Allah, because this is known as love along with Allah. الآية الخامسة, the fifth ayah, قوله وقل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا. And say, O praises due to Allah who has not begotten a son nor any offspring, and who has no partner in his dominion, nor he is low to have a wali, protector or supporter, and magnify him with all magnificence. And then say basically Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah. وقل, say, الخطاب في مثل هذا, such address, إما خاص بالرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام, it's either specific and exclusive to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أو عام لكل من يصح توجيه الخطاب إليه, or it could be general and applicable to anyone whom you could address. فإذا كان خاصا بالرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام فهو خاص به بالقصد الأول وأمته تبعا له. If the Prophet ﷺ is being specifically addressed, then it becomes specific to him initially, and we as his ummah, we follow him. We are followers of him عليه الصلاة والسلام. وإن كان عاماً however if the address in its essence is general فهو يشمل الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام وغيره بالقصد الأول so then it encompasses the Prophet ﷺ and all his followers combined from the beginning. الحمد لله سبق تفسير هذه الجملة. We've already explained this sentence. وأن الحمد هو وصف المحمود بالكمال مع المحبة والتعظيم. And حمد means to describe the one who is praised with perfection along with love and exaltation. وقوله لله اللام هنا للاستحقاق والاختصاص. الاستحقاق meaning for basically here it means for entitlement. It's a preposition to mean entitlement. لأن الله تعالى يحمد وهو أهل الحمد. Because Allah عز وجل is praised and He is worthy. He is worthy of praise. والاختصاص and specifically specification لأن الحمد الذي يحمد الله به ليس كالحمد الذي يحمد بغيره. The praise which Allah is praised with is not like the praise that others are praised with. بل هو أكمل وأعظم وأعم وأشمل. Rather it is more perfect and it is greater and it is more encompassing and it is more comprehensive. وقوله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا who has not begotten a son. هذه من الصفات السلبية. This is an attribute of negation. لم يتخذ ولدا. He did not beget a son. لكمال صفاته وكمال غناه عن غيره. Because of the perfection of the attributes of Allah and the perfection of his his self-sufficiency from others. ولأنه لا مثيل له. And because Allah has no equal. فلو اتخذ ولدا had Allah taken a son لكان الولد مثله. Then the son would have been like Allah. لو كان له ولد, if Allah had a son, لكان محتاجا إلى الولد يساعده ويعينه. Allah would have been in need of having a son who will help him and aid him. ولو كان له ولد, had Allah had a son, لكان ناقصا. Allah would have been deficient. لأنه إذا شبه أحد من خلقه فهو نقص. Because if any one of his creation resemble him, that becomes a deficiency in and of itself. And these are, by the way, يعني logical arguments that you can also use in giving da'wah to Christians. You see? I remember when I was ignorant of the teachings of Islam and I was attempting to give da'wah to certain people in my life in Christianity, who were Christian, even though I had not yet learned like Islam, I was still like on a Sufi tip, just barely learning how to read the Quran with tajweed and you know doing the adhkar in the morning and the evening in congregation. And I was completely yani, off the track because I had no other person to guide me. I had no one in my circle to show me the true way. But I remember that I gave da'wah to Christians, certain Christians, using those very logical sound arguments that really no one can mess with. يعني even if you don't have knowledge, Allah gave us a fitra and gave us reason enough for you to be able to navigate through this, even if you don't have a vast amount of knowledge of the Bible and the Quranic ayat which are used to give da'wah. Of course, I'm not saying that you should go out to give da'wah according to just your, you know, reasoning and without knowledge, but I'm saying that even at that very level in my experience, you're able to actually persuade someone that, wait a second, what do you mean God has a son? Like the most basic argument. If Jesus is God, did Jesus die? And any Christian will basically crumble in front of this argument. They say Jesus is God because it's a triune God, Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Did Jesus die? They say yes. So did God die? No. Why? Because the Father was there. But you said that the Father and the Son are co-equal. So if they're co-equal, that means when the Son died, the Father died as well. Or if Jesus died, then how could He be God? Does God die? And just throw this at the average Christian, and you will hear, literally, you will hear 10,000 answers from 2,000 Christians. Everybody will give you all types of nonsensical answers that they have nothing to substantiate. It's just whatever comes to mind. Oh, well, because, you know, he wanted to be human and he wanted to show us what it's like to suffer. Says who? What do you mean he wanted to show us? What is this incapable God? What is this incapable God that is unable to get things done so that he has to go out of his way and humiliate himself to deliver a message to us? What in the world are you talking about? God is about might and power. God is not about helplessness and weakness so that he has to show us and become a man and get humiliated for us to understand what suffering is like. Cut the nonsense. And why did he not do this with Noah and Adam and Abraham and David and Solomon and all these prophets before him? He was using the wrong means and methods the entire existence of humanity, and he only figured it out by the time Jesus came around that he wanted to. What in the world are you saying? And the Christians are funny people, man. The Christians are some of the funniest people on earth. And that's why a lot of them come to Islam, because when you hit them with that brick, then it's like, whoa, wait. Because they never think about that stuff. You know, they take it face value. They take it face value. وقوله ولد then يشمل الذكر والأنثى. So the statement ولد includes actually a male or a female. ففيه الرد على اليهود والنصارى والمشركين. In that is a refutation against the Jews, the Christians, and the polytheists. اليهود قالوا لله ولد هو عزير. So the Jews said that Allah has a son, his name is عزير. والنصارى قالوا لله ولد وهو المسيح. The Christians say Allah has a son and it is the Messiah. والمشركون قالوا لله ولد هو الملائكة. And the polytheists said Allah has children and they are the angels. وقوله ولم يكن له شريك في الملك. Allah عز وجل says and he did not have any partner in his dominion. هذا معطوف على قوله لم يتخذ ولدا. And this is joined with the statement of Allah عز وجل, he did not beget a son. يعني والذي لم يكن له شريك في الملك لا في الخلق ولا في الملك ولا في التدبير. Meaning and the one who has no partners in his dominion. Not in creating, not in ownership, and not in the arranging of the affairs. كُلُّ مَا سِوَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ مَخْلُوقٌ لِلَّهِ. Whatever is besides Allah is a creation of Allah. مَمْلُوكٌ لَهِ. He is a property of Allah. Is a property of Allah. يُدَبِّرُهُ كَمَا يَشَاءُ. Allah Azza wa Jal controls and disposes of his affairs as he wills. وَلَمْ يُشَارِكُهُ أَحَدٌ فِي ذَلِكَ. And no one partnered with Allah Azza wa Jal and shared with Allah this matter. كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى. As Allah says, قُلِ ادْعُوا الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Say, call upon those whom you assert to be associate gods besides Allah. They possess not even the weight of a speck either in the heavens or on the earth. عجيب. على سبيل التعين وما لهم فيهما من شرك. Allah Azza wa Jalla says nor have they any share in either. على سبيل الشيوع. This is generality. وما له منهم من ظهير. And Allah Azza wa Jalla nor there's any for him any supporter from among them. لم يعاونه أحد في هذه السماوات والأرض. No one aided Allah in these heavens and the earth. ولا تنفع الشفاعة عنده إلا لمن أذل له. Intercession with him profits no one except for him whom he permits. وبهذا تقطع جميع الأسباب التي يتعلق بها المشركون في آلهتهم. With this, all of the means, all of those connections that those mushrikeen are trying to associate with Allah, all of those connections have been cut off. The ones that the mushrikeen rely upon in their shirk with their false gods, all of them Allah Azza wa Jal has cut off. They have no partnership with him. Allah did not take any assistance from among them. None of them will be able to intercede for you except with this permission. Khalas, khalas, there's nothing left. So say this now to those so-called Muslims who have a grave and they're doing tawaf around this grave. Doing tawaf. Calling on, you know, this man. Like, ya Shaykh, not even, astaghfirullah, a dead man. A dead man, you don't even know his condition with Allah. He could be tortured. He could be getting tortured in his grave. They call on him. And then some people come and say, this is haram. No shirk, not shirk. Because they don't think that they have divine attributes. They don't think that they're a God per se. عجيب يا أخي عجيب. سبحان الله العظيم سبحان الله العظيم سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله. فالآلية هذه لا تملك من السماوات والأرض شيئا معينا. So those gods do not possess of the heavens and the earth anything in particular. وليست شريكة لله. And it is not a partner with Allah. ولا معينة ولا معينة. And it is not a supporter. ولا شافعة. It is not an intercessor. إلا بإذن. Except this permission. يقول ولم يكن له شريك في الملك. And Allah عز وجل did not have any partners in his dominion. وقوله ولم يكن له ولي من الذل. Allah عز وجل did not have any partner. Where is it? Allah عز وجل did not have any ولي, a rival. لكنه قيد بقوله من الذل. Now هنا we're going to discuss what is intended by من الذل. ومن هنا للتعليل, لأن الله تعالى له أولياء. Allah عز وجل does have أولياء. Allah does have friends. Allah عز وجل does have friends. You know that already, right? طيب. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. So verily, the أولياء of Allah عز وجل, the أولياء of Allah عز وجل, no doubt, no fear shall come upon them, nor shall they grieve, those who believed and used to have taqwa. الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. وقال تعالى في الحديث القدسي, الله عز وجل says in the حديث قدسي, من عاد لي وليا فقد أذنته بالحرب. Whosoever shows enmity towards a wali, a friend of mine, I declare war against him. ولكن الولي المنفي هو الولي من الذل. The wali that is being negated here is the one required due to lowliness. لأن الله تعالى له العزة جميعا, because Allah has all might. فلا يلحق الذل بوجه من الوجوه. Allah is not associated with any humility in any way, shape or form. لكمال عزتي, because the perfection of Allah's might. So this is what is intended from من الذل, meaning out of lowliness and out of humility. وقوله وكبره تكبيرا, يعني كبر الله عز وجل تكبيرا, meaning magnify Allah عز وجل, the sublime with all magnificence. بلسانك وجنانك, with your tongue and with your heart. اعتقد في قلبك أن الله أكبر من كل شيء. Know in your heart that Allah عز وجل is greater than everything. وأن له الكبرياء في السماوات والأرض. And Allah has the magnificence and the exaltation in the heavens and in the earth. وكذلك بلسانك تكبره فتقول الله أكبر. And similarly, you have this grandeur of Allah عز وجل in your heart, so you say الله أكبر. You mean it when you say it. وكان من هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه أنهم يكبرون كلما علوا نشزا. It was from the way of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that any time they ascended on a high place, they would say الله أكبر. أي مرتفعا, a place that is above the ground, above ground level. وهذا في السفر, and this is in travel. لأن الإنسان إذا على في مكانه, because if you go up in a place, قد يشعر في قلبي أن مستعلى على غيري. You may feel in your heart that you're higher. If you ascend on a place, you may feel that you're bigger and greater than others. فيقول الله أكبر. So he says Allah is the greatest, so he can put himself in his place. من أجل أن يخفف تلك العلياء التي شعر بها حين على وارتفع. So that you may minimize this kind of arrogance that you might have had, or this feeling of being above that you might have attained whenever you've gotten on a high thing and tried. If you go on to the top of the mountain, you know, what do the people say? You know, I'm on top of the world. You know, I'm blah, 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 something like that. You feel that you've controlled and you've dominated, you've conquered basically the mountain, the top of the mountain. So you get that feeling of you know, exalting yourself. وَكَانُوا إِذَا هَبَطُوا. Similarly, whenever they would descend, whenever they would go down, قالوا سبحان الله, they would say how perfect is Allah. لأن النزول سفول, because going down is belittlement. فيقول سبحان الله, so you say how perfect is Allah. ينزه من عن السفول الذي أنا الآن فيه, meaning I glorify Allah above the lowliness that I am in right now. See how beautiful that is. وقوله تكبير, هذا مصدر مؤكد يراد به التعظيم, أي كبره تكبيرا عظيما. And so this is anyways, it's for emphasis, تكبير here for emphasis, meaning magnify him and glorify him in the ultimate way. Okay, it looks like we got a long way to go, so I'm better off stopping. Actually, let me finish this, then we go to the sixth ayah inshallah next time. والذي نستفيد من ناحية المسلكية في هذه الآية. What do we get from the behavioral benefit in this آية؟ أن الإنسان يشعر بكمال غنى الله عز وجل عن كل أحد. You should feel in your heart the perfection and the self-sufficiency of Allah above everyone. وانفراده بالملك and the sole dominionship of Allah عز وجل. وتمام عزتي وسلطاني and the perfection of Allah's might and control. وحينئذ يعظم الله سبحانه وتعالى بما يستحق أن يعظم به بقدر استطاعته. Therefore, this will lead you to glorify and magnify Allah سبحانه وتعالى tremendously to the best of your ability. ونستفيد حمد الله تعالى على تنزهه من عن العيوب كما يحمد على صفات الكمال. And we also benefit that we should praise Allah عز وجل for being perfect, for being above any imperfection, just like we praise Allah عز وجل for having all the attributes of perfection. So we praise Allah for having the attributes of perfection and also to declare Him to be free of any type of defect. And with this, inshallah, we conclude بإذن الله عز وجل. If we remain alive and healthy, next week we will go to the sixth ayah in regards to the subject matter. And we will see what Allah عز وجل facilitates. We are coming close to finishing the first book from these two volumes. It's two volumes. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to facilitate and to make it beneficial. Let's see if you have any questions. Since yesterday we had a crazy Q&A, some of you weren't able to get your questions answered. So let me see if I could hook you up right now with a couple of, with a few minutes, inshallah. Aina people. Aina al people. What are the qualities that a man must strive to possess before getting married? Well, you should be manly, you should be brave, you should be strong. This is of course after having taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal and learning this, the religion of Islam. A sound woman that is not sick in the mind, who hasn't been brainwashed and affected by the feminist movement, wants to be submissive to a man. A proper woman is submissive to a man. She wants a man to be in control. Not a dictator, not a jerk, but a man who's in control. A man who will look after her, take care of her, and put her under his wing. Not another woman who is, vulnerable and weak and silly. A man should also have a sense of humor, and you should be friendly and kind. And you should also be firm and assertive. And this is something that you learn with experience, you learn with time. And of course, we're all imperfect. We all have problems. We try to be a certain way, but we fail. Nevertheless, this is the objective. The objective is to have a target and aim at reaching it. So a woman wants a man, nowadays there are men who want men. But a woman wants a man who will take care of her, and who will take leadership in the house, who will be the boss. That is a proper woman. So make sure that you marry this type of woman. Don't marry a tomboy who's gonna, tell you, I will decide and I will call the shots and you go, I will go work and you stay at home, you do the dishes, make me lasagna, make me spaghetti. All this nonsense is just modernism. I'm not saying that a man cannot cook. A man can cook if he enjoys cooking, but for his wife to impose on him cooking while she watches TV, that's just crazy. Okay, that's just, that man might as well put on a skirt and, go fix his makeup in the bathroom. So you got to know your role, Habibi. Look at the Prophet ﷺ, how he was. He would take care of his own stuff also. A man doesn't have to be so dependent and reliant on others, even regarding his children. It's good to ask for your children for stuff, your wife for stuff, and there are times when you just have to handle your own business. Do your own thing. Be self-sufficient and independent. Ay, wallahu a'lam. Shukran ya lachu. Tayyib. Hayyallah Abu Sufyan Milad. Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dr. Mickey Mouse himself. What should we do regarding the people who call to nationalism and unity on a specific race? We should abandon those people. People like the Fiches and others of this nature, those individuals that are about, black unity and black nationalism, يا أخي الله يرضى عليك يا أخي الله created all mankind from Adam and Eve whether you black white yellow pink brown who cares who cares who cares we call to the unity of faith the unity of Muslims we don't care about your nationality you shouldn't care about your nationality it shouldn't be a criteria for division just like when the al-muhajirin wal ansar had that little glitch where they had a little difference and they started ya muhajirin one of them called ya muhajirin one of ansar prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam became angry said da'uha fa innaha natina leave it alone it is filthy just calling the muhajirin as muhajirin ansar as ansar in a sense to make that division among the muslims was something the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited and those were valid descriptions of people that came from Mecca versus people that welcomed the Prophet ﷺ in Medina. What about then white people and black people and Indian people and Arab people? خلي ولي يا شيخ. السلام عليكم شيخ. وعليكم السلام. I'm not a sheikh. My aunt want to ask that can she cover up her missed prayers which she left at her younger age? Is there a concept of kaja umri? Namaj, to cover each prayer missed, wallah al-azim, yani I need to learn 18 languages to understand what you're asking, ya sahal. What in the world is kaja umri namaj? Isn't it first namaz that you guys say? Anyways, man, it depends on what position she follows. If she follows the position that abandoning the salah is an act of kufr, then she doesn't have to make up her missed prayers because she was a disbeliever. If she follows a position that she was still a believer, then she has to make up all of these salawat. Yes. So every time she prays Fajr, she prays two. Every time she prays Asr, she prays two Asr, two Dhuhr, two Maghrib, two Isha, for as long as she can, until she feels that she has fulfilled and made up her previous abandonment of the salah. Wallahu musta'an. Assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam. I know a brother who is very close to me. When I speak to him, he says to me, be more lenient. And there are good Sufis. He promotes Tablighi. Well, you need to give him da'wah, bro. Let him watch some of my lectures. Maybe he will change his mind. If I pay zakah on 8th of Sha'ban, do I pay the next year before 8th of Sha'ban? Is this considered a year? Barakallah fiqh. Yes. No. If you paid it on the 8th of Sha'ban of 1441, then the 8th of Sha'ban of 1442 is when the zakah is due. If you want to pay it in advance, you could. But it counts as a year after that time has passed. What are the beliefs of Ash'aris? Oh, come on, man. You have 41 sessions to watch. Tasfiya. Tasfiya, wa alaikum salam, sister. I'm guessing you're a sister. Go back and watch 41 sessions of Al-Aqidah Al-Wasitiyah. You will know exactly who the Ash'aris are. He also calls me a super Salafi because I say it's best to stay away from those who you know that are Sufi and other misguided sects with all these statements and ideologies. Should I stay away? No, you should not stay away. You should give him da'wah. At least you're not Superman. There are so many WhatsApp stickers of yours. They're great. Who makes them? This one brother, mashallah, tabarakallah, was into this making stickers business, and I didn't mind it, honestly. Yeah, I have those stickers. I don't know how you have them. Is it permissible in the Sharia to congratulate a woman who had a child outside wedlock? congratulate her on what? Well, I think that zina session you had was tremendous. Congratulations. What do you think? Assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam. Do you think racism exists? Durr. Of course it exists. It's all over the place. Assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam, Ustad. Can I get your WhatsApp number or is there any way I can contact you? I don't know how to answer that question. Yeah, you can contact me. You're contacting me right now. You can get my WhatsApp number, but if I put it here, everybody's gonna harass me. Give me a solution. Assalamu alaikum, brother, wa alaikum salam, Mr. Sayyid Fahad. Amatullah, assalamu alaikum. Just a couple of questions. Wa alaikum salam. Bring it on. Brother, I changed my name, just a person. Oh, you were the random guy? You became just a person? It's an improvement, akhi, but you're not quite there. What the heck? Are you gonna do it in installments, man? Every other day you're gonna change? Just call yourself whatever your name is. If your name is Zabu'a Mabu'a, just be Zabu'a Mabu'a, brother. Why is the Hadith Qudsi not in the Quran? Because it's a Hadith Qudsi. It's not the Quran. Why would it be in the Quran? If Allah wanted it to be in the Quran, it would have been in the Quran. Are all the Imams of Haramain Sharifain on correct Aqidah? I don't know. I didn't sit with any of them and have a discussion about the subject matter. I have watched episode 12 of the series, I think about Qadr, twice, but I still don't understand. Okay, watch my lecture. Do I have a choice? Watch my lecture, Ya Amatullah Su. I have a lecture titled, Do I Have a Choice? It is a compressed, encapsulated version of the concept of Qadr, which inshallah will make more sense to you than the class. I know the class may be a little sophisticated. Salams to you, brother, and every Sami from the UK. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Why every Sami from the UK? Others are not entitled to the salam, Ya Samir. Why are you dressed like a soldier? I'm not, it's just a shirt. Do you see me carrying any other stuff? It's just a shirt. If I stand up, you'll see my sleeping pants, my pajamas. Then you're going to laugh at me and tell me, what kind of soldier is this? aren't you going to upload the ProfCon session in your channel here? I don't think so. I wasn't happy with it, to be honest with you, in terms of the quality, in terms of I got cut off so many times, I couldn't even collect my thoughts. I think I did a terrible job. If you think racism exists, then why do you criticize BLM? Because I criticize BLM because I don't want the fact that racism, the existence of racism, should not make me counter it with another racist movement. Why do I have to call something Black Lives Matter? Why not Chinese Lives Matter, Muslim Lives Matter, White People Lives Matter, Indian Lives Matter, Sri Lankan Lives Matter? Everybody has issues, man. It's not just black people. I would call it Muslim Lives Matter, because what I care about is the Muslims. That's how I see things. I just care about religion. I don't care about race. And what is Black Lives Matter as an organization? It's an organization that promotes, you know, homosexuality and transgenders. And you look at their statement, their mission statement, or whatever they call it. It's an evil organization. I love black people equally, like I love white people, like I love Indian people, like I love Filipinos, like I love everybody. I don't care. If you're a Muslim, I love you for the sake of Allah. If you're not a Muslim, I couldn't care less about you. Your race is not important. This is me. This is how I see things. I see them very black and white in this regard. yalla guys, we're over the time limit. How can I reconcile between Qadr, Khair and Shar? Sister, watch the lecture. Whatchamacallit? Okay, you got it already. Is it okay to allow kids to watch Disney? No. Be careful. I mean, I don't know. It really depends. But are you going to find a Disney movie with no music and no nakedness and no magic and no shirk in it? If you find one, let me know what it is. In my school, no one gives salam to teachers. I feel like a stranger advice. All are Muslim except one. Okay, good that you feel like a stranger. It's good for you, brother. Oh, there's Raihan, the sticker guy. Allah, because I'm wearing this, I'm reminding you of Anwar al-Awlaqi. Let me take off the shirt. Astaghfirullah. Guys, it's a fashion. It's not anything beyond that. Allah musta'an. Allah musta'an. Type. For marriage meetings, is it haram to speak to the person if you're happy to speak to that person with that wali? No, it's not. As long as the wali's there. Can we watch Arabic cartoons in which there's no music? Yes. Can I pray in a Diobandi masjid that has the name of the Prophet and the name of Allah next to each other? Yes, pray and leave. Oh man, guys, mashallah, you love to ask questions. I was having an argument in regards to what Yasir Qadi said about the grave, and he showed me the hadith about Prophet ﷺ said, call on the angel. Is that a sahih hadith? No. I don't know what you're talking about. Tayyib, yalla. That is enough for today. The Ajrumiyyah is so complicated. Maybe one day. Maybe one day, inshallah. I did teach that Ajrumiyyah once to some close friends of mine in a private environment. It was a family of people, actually, dear to us. But we never even completed the book. But ala kulli hal. Okie dokie. Yalla, enough. طيب جزاكم الله خير، سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.